Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, I'm going to share with you a report design to try and get your brain thinking about possibilities inside of Power BI. It's going to build on something we've already done. It's going to take it to the next level and go beyond. Do you want to see it? Of course you do. Let's go. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. I am not a master at report designs. I'm just going to admit that. I borrow or get inspiration from other people. In this case, this was actually a report design that Chris Hamill from the Power BI Cat team had put together. And when I saw that, I was like, oh, this looks pretty cool. I like this. And then Patrick saw it and he told me, he's like, dude, you should do a video on this and show people how to build this. Like I said, this builds on something we've done before, and I'm gonna add other elements of this and explain it to you and take it to the next level. I'm not a report design expert, so if I can do this, you can do this. And this is what I love about Chris Hamill's reports. When he puts it together, it's something anyone can put together. It's simple, it's clean, and I love it. All right. Enough of all this talking, you know we like to do here on Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. Here is the report. I love it. It's simple. It conveys information. It lets you put a dashboard together. In this case, there were three different pillars, and you can configure these any way you want. You could have one pillar, you could have two pillars, three pillars. What I did before that I'm building on is I did a video a while back on info panels, and this was a way that you can put information out there to help explain how to use the report. So in this case, we've got this question mark up in the upper right, and if I go and click on it, bam, there's our info panel, right? So I've got some information here to say, hey, you can click on these little ellipsis things, and you can also click on these information items. If you've got an idea or an issue with it, here you can go contact, email out, and also when was this data last refreshed, right? And then I can click on the X, or I can just click anywhere on that image and have the info panel go away. Cool. So the next thing I've got here is this little information button here. And so for each one of these, you can configure it separately. So in this case, it'll actually give information about the data that they're seeing. So you can put whatever you want here, right? Or as much detail as you want here. So you can explain how this is being calculated. You'll notice we've got some acronyms here like YTD and SPLY and POP. People may not be familiar with those acronyms. So here I spell these out so that they know what exactly that means. And this is in the context of this one pillar. So you can have these for each of the other pillars as well, because they're using different data points. But this is clean with inside of the design so that it's just not funky or takes up unneeded space or anything like that. And then the last thing I have here is this ellipsis up here. So if I click on that, now we get this expanded information about what can I dig into here and what can I actually click on, right? So I can slice and dice and all of this interacts. And then I can go ahead and click out and get out of that extended design. That's bananas. Like, it's so cool that you can incorporate things into the report that make it more like an application type feel, but you can give that extended information. So if you want to see that quick look, that's cool. But if you want to drill in just a little bit more, you can go ahead and do that. One other thing you could incorporate too, if it made sense, is we've got the sales amounts. Maybe these line numbers, you had something else you wanted to put in the showcase and you still wanted to have this information though. You could do like a report level tooltip over this. That's just something to think about. So now you may be sitting there going like, hey, Adam, that's really cool, but how did you do that? Let's reveal the magic. One thing in the background, you see, you've got these pillars, right? So I've got my blue, my red, and my yellowish color. They've got some titles on there. Then there's these boxes and kind of colors and whatnot. Now, one thing you'll notice though, is if I click on this background, there's no actual image, there's no visual, there's no nothing, right? I can't select product, right? I can't select focus three. So how did I do this? Well, one of the things that Chris always says is to use PowerPoint to create these. Patrick's done a video on that as well. So I did just that. In PowerPoint, I created the background. It's baking in all of these things into the background image as much as I can, as much as what's static is there. These text boxes like sales info, products, other, focus, 1 through 3, I don't need to have a text box. So that gets rid of 6 visuals. And then these boxes, the blue, red, and yellow, those would be shapes. So that's 9 visuals right there that I'm avoiding in the report because I'm baking it into the background object. Also, these potential borders and highlights, if you did shapes for this, so that's what, 15 visuals? On on top of the other nine. That's a lot of visuals that I've just baked into the background image. So if we go to page, to canvas background, I've got my background image, I've set it to fit, and the transparency is down on zero. That's all I did there. For these card visuals, it's just a regular card visual with a transparent background, or you could even do white because it's white in this case, and then just size it into that box and you're good to go. And then what I did is I copy and pasted it so that the size and everything was the same, but there's other ways you can do that. And then these visuals here, they're just regular visuals that are inside of that given area. So now what about the overlay? Again, I just did this inside of PowerPoint. So I created the arrows, I created the text boxes. The only piece of data that's actually on this is the date from the data model of when it was last refreshed. Just do a select all inside of PowerPoint and then right click and do save as picture. So make sure all those other items in the background are not selected. And then you can get your transparent image that I just bring in as an image into the report itself. So if we look inside of the image, set it to fit, and you are good to go. So the last thing here is inside of PowerPoint, I've got another image background that I created, except instead of it actually being the background itself, I actually have it as an image. So if I just select it, you'll see it comes kind of the front, and it's actually sitting behind these items. So the actual visuals, they're going to be in the same spot, but the items in the extended are sitting on top of it. And then the rest of this, in order to control what's being shown and what's not being shown, is all some bookmarks and selection magic. So I've got my base state here. If I'm going to sales info short, that's going to hide the extended panel. If I go to full, that brings up the panel, and you'll see that it's hiding all of the products and other components. And then it just sits on top of whatever the actual background image is for the overall report. And then info panel, same thing, not visible. Visible, that's regardless of what else is behind it. And then I've got my base state, and then not visible, and then sales description. So these are all just bookmarks that are controlling visibility. And then the buttons are aligned to those bookmarks itself. The big thing that I've shown in my mastering bookmarks video, make sure you do selective visuals and make sure you've got the right visual selected when you're creating these bookmarks. So that's how I can have my info panel on top of other stuff and not be destroyed when I hit other bookmarks, right? So if this is visible and I go into full, it's not touching the overlay because my bookmarks are only tied to specific selected visuals. The info panel is independent of what else is going on. Whew. That's a lot of info. So I've got videos on the info panel. I've got videos on mastering bookmarks. Go check those out to make sure that you understand how bookmarks work. And then it's just Legos, right? You're just putting the different pieces in there and making sure that they interact correctly. Not a lot of magic, right? This is simple stuff you can do inside of your reports. Special shout out to Chris Hamill for doing this report design and inspiring me for this video. If you love this report design or the concepts in here, let me know in the comments below or share other ways that you've done reports. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.